want to make a podcast? Spotify's got a platform that's going to let you make one super easily. And then you can distribute it everywhere and even earn money doing this. All in one place. And it's free. It's called Spotify for Podcasters. Here's how it works. Spotify for Podcasters lets you record and even edit your podcast right from your phone or your computer. Then you can distribute your podcast to Spotify and everywhere else podcasts are heard.
You know, ever since we discovered Spotify for Podcasters, it's been really great. Really get the people involved and ask questions and get ideas for new podcasts. So it's really helped us. And, you know, I highly recommend you give it a try. So download the Spotify for Podcasters app or go to www.spotify.com/podcasters to get started.
Fool me, we can't get fooled again.
In Dallas, Texas, three shots were fired at President Kennedy's motorcade in downtown Dallas.
December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy.
You don't know what you're talking about, sir.
Because people have got to know whether or not their president's a crook. Well, I'm not a crook. I've earned everything I've got.
If you don't like what we tell you to believe in, we'll kill you.
All right, kids. Listen.
Podcast. Don't listen to this.
If you're not of age.
What's of age?
This is 18 and up. Look, a bunch of dudes, and we're going to say some really bad words and probably some things that might offend you, but
don't listen to this.
Can't wait till you listen.
Yeah, don't.
If you're 18 and up,
don't do it.
If you're 18
and up. Yeah.
All right, everybody, welcome back to the Conspiracy Podcast. This is the death of Paul McCartney. We got Sean. We got Jorge.
What up?
And we got Eric.
Welcome back, guys.
Like, Eric takes no shout out.
This is the episode on the Beatles. Not quite the Beatles.
It's Paul McCartney.
Right. It's Paul McCartney.
Yeah.
The fake dead swap. Paul McCartney.
Yeah. Is Paul McCartney actually dead? And then there's just a body double.
Yeah.
Waltzing around rich.
Right. This one's weird. It's a little bit before my time.
It's before both all of our times, bro.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. But it continues to be
one of the top.
It's all in the top 10 lists.
All 40 episodes have been in the top 10.
It's true.
Everything is top 10.
Yeah. It is strange, though. It continues to persist.
I know, which is weird.
You know what I mean? Like,
that's what true conspiracies do.
Yeah. But these.
They persist.
As long as there's a believer. As long as there's one believer out there.
And I don't feel like we need to really go into the insanity of the Beatles.
No, everyone knows the Beatles. Yeah. I think every person, even if you're five, you know the Beatles.
Like, yeah. Like, they were huge. Like
massive. They grew the biggest.
Like, ridiculous. You know what you should do? You know, as a good exercise on this one, is go watch the videos of fan reactions. And
yes.
There's these chicks that lose their mind.
Like, literally. Like,
they're out of control.
Freak the fuck out.
Yeah, they're like, oh, I'm wanting to bang them. It's like a whole thing.
Which is so weird because I once again, I've never felt that about anybody.
On anything?
No.
I mean,
but you were saying it was before our times. So I did see that with Michael Jackson.
Oh,
same
for
shit.
Sure.
Yeah. Same shit. Like,
I mean, Michael Jackson. Michael Jackson owned the Beatles.
Yeah. Elvis?
Oh, for sure.
Yeah.
Oh,
that
yeah.
Too,
Elvis had it.
But that was also a different time where people were much more conservative.
Yeah.
And they're like, I'll take my tits out for you right now.
Like, they broke.
They broke all the social norms. Or, yeah. To do.
Frank Sinatra? Maybe? Yeah. No, he was a crooner.
Maybe not on that level, but.
He was a you know, what do they call it? A crooner?
I don't know.
Yeah.
Well, first of all, fuck Frank Sinatra. Ever since the Maryland episode.
Sean hates him.
Dude, I can't get behind him.
You can't even say his name around him.
I don't even want to. Fuck Frank Sinatra. Fuck a piece of shit. Fly me to the... Every time I hear him, I'm like, fuck you.
Yeah. Anyway, so the Beatles were that. And they were... And honestly, I feel like this conspiracy comes from that.
Oh, this just the...
People were so insane about them that... That insanity breeds
insanity.
Yeah, yeah, more, you know, more insanity. Or at least conspiracies.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yes, exactly.
It's true. And think about it, the really big, really, really famous people, Bob Marley,
yeah.
Tupac, I don't know, Beatles, like there's
all
always
Kurt Cobain,
yeah, yeah. Right. We just
they,
did that.
Yeah, they all lead to
Michael Jackson.
Because there's like, I don't
there's
know,
maybe, the big conspiracy around that, yeah, too.
We maybe like people feel they have to make something up to kind of make sense.
Yeah, because it doesn't, yeah, they can't be gone.
But maybe, this is a little bit different.
Yeah, maybe this is my long, this is a long term lesson, huh?
Don't get so famous.
No, I mean, like, you. The, most
the
of the conspiracies
we're be doing.
Are because like,
no, because they're so legendary and they're so
that they,
out of the norm
that they couldn't have died regularly.
Yes,
like it has to be.
It couldn't have been a normal
existential, the crazy circumstances that
they,
had to occur.
They couldn't have choked on a church's chicken, you know, or I don't know.
Sounds some, good. I could eat some church.
Sean's getting hungry.
I am. I ate, but I'm like hungry still. I'm still hungry.
Little fried chicken from churches.
Like, me hungry.
Straight up, I'm going to get some Mickey D's after this. I'm not even lying. I'm like 100%. 100%.
It's on the way.
Okay, so.
It is on the way. Yeah.
That's what I'm saying.
So this episode is about the death of Paul McCartney. Now, Paul McCartney's not dead.
He's alive.
Just so we're all clear.
Yeah. Right. This is the conspiracy
of his death, right? And he's still, to this day, probably one of the biggest musicians
ever
on the scene, right?
Yeah, ever.
Yeah.
Unless you subscribe to this conspiracy.
That's right.
Mm.
That's
right. He was one of the biggest musicians on the scene.
So we're going to go into the story. I'm going to tell you this story based on it being the real story, but it's not the story necessarily.
But
well, you make the decision.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a story, and then you'll decide whether it's real
That's
or fake.
Right. It's kind of like Quentin Tarantino, you know, at the end of Inglourious Bastards, Hitler dies in a fire.
I know, right?
And you're like, well, it's not the story.
Well,
but
Hitler doesn't die in a fire. Hitler dies by getting shot by two MP40s from a balcony and then gets burnt. And then the whole building explodes, which obviously is not factual.
But he really fled, is the real story.
to Argentina?
Yeah.
We did a whole episode on that, by the way, guys, if you haven't listened
to
that.
You know, I do want to go back to that one.
You do?
I do.
Do like a update? Like a,
yeah, because I feel like we could go even deeper. Yeah, we could go deeper on that one. Anyways.
We should go to Argentina. We should find out for ourselves.
For sure.
Yeah.
Go
put on the list.
Bring some jeans.
Yeah. Soon, soon subscribe to our Patreon, which will be coming out soon.
Yeah.
Help us go to Argentina.
So on the, late in the evening of November 9th, 1966, Paul McCartney left EMI Studios, and he was tired, sad, dejected, and he just got into a fight with his bandmates during a Sgt. Pepper recording session. Okay, specifically with John Lennon. They got into an argument.
You want to clarify Sgt. Pepper just in case?
It's an album that they were coming out with. Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
And a really big album that came out. And one of their last albums that they did together. So they got into a fight, supposedly.
Fuck you, John.
Supposedly.
Okay, Paul. Fuck you.
Oh, yes. Accents. I'm super pumped. Are you?
Okay, Paul. Listen here, Paul.
Fuck you, Roy.
All right. If I come out here again.
Yes. Oh, I need like 10 more of those. Okay.
In it.
Like that's
my favorite. Yeah. It's my favorite English phrase. In it.
We're starting to break through into Europe, and so we're gonna get a lot of love from our.
Like it's gonna go from like 3% to 0%.
Our British folk out there.
I don't know. It's terrible.
That is super bad.
Super bad.
Stop.
Just leave the accents to me, bro.
Woo.
Anyway.
Okay, so they get into this massive argument.
Pissed.
And this is very early in the morning, 4 or 5 in the morning.
Jesus.
I mean, when you're rock stars, you do some crazy shit.
And there's also no concept of time because your life is do whatever you want.
They were awake and it's 4 or 5 in the morning.
Yeah.
That's different.
But I mean, so.
Who the hell wakes up at 4 or 5 in the morning?
No,
they're probably awake.
So,
they're probably recording. Yeah. They're probably there for
a while. Imagine our podcast is just crazy huge and. We're so rich that we don't even subscribe to time anymore.
No. Yeah. It's just like...
You know what I mean?
Yeah. My wife's like, what are you doing? I'm like, whatever I want.
No. You don't even talk to your wife.
I'll see you when I'm home.
Yeah,
ask no questions.
Yeah, like, you live in mansion A. She lives in mansion C.
But they're connected.
Yeah.
They're all part of the same mansion.
So, anyway, so they're doing this big recording session and they get into this fight. So he storms out of there and he decides to leave and he gets into his 1966 Aston Martin, of course.
Of course. Because you're that rich.
Yeah.
Love it.
So per this story, on his way home, he sees a hitchhiker named Rita.
Mm-hmm.
He picks her up. He picks her up.
I mean, what rich person has ever picked up a hitchhiker ever?
Super rich and famous.
And ultra famous. It's not like she's not going to know who you are.
Ultra famous.
Even the bums are like, the Beatles. I'm like, what the fuck?
So he picks her up.
Is it come back to my hotel?
Starts
baby.
Doing a little thing thing.
Oh, of course. They instantly start boning.
Thing thing.
Like, she gets in the car and she's like, all right.
Here we go.
One of the original stories is she was trying to make out with him while he was driving.
Oh, she's trying to make out with his dick. Come on, let me kiss it, please. Well, that's not really British.
Please, sir. May I have another, sir? So she's trying to do the thing thing, right? Because it's Paul McCartney.
Paul McCartney, dude.
You know what I mean? She's like, hey.
I'd probably try to do the thing thing. Right? Like, I know, honestly. I know. Like, come on.
Yeah.
I got you, bro.
Thanks for that.
Of which he got distracted. He drives off the road.
Hmm.
In the crash, his head is cut off.
Whoa.
Ah.
Decapitated.
Okay, where's this story coming from? Like, who's where's data coming from? Okay,
let me finish the story. Okay. Let me finish the story.
Okay. Yeah.
So his head's decapitated. Then police arrive on the scene and they go, oh my God, it's the head of Paul McCartney.
Ah! They're like, holding ah!
It's raining. They call in the people and then they come.
Then they bring the paddy wagon.
Yeah, and they come. John Lennon comes down. Ringo Starr comes down, you know, and they identify the head.
How do they have their numbers? Call Ringo.
They found his cell phone.
This isn't like there was before cell phone.
He dies, right? And then they hold the funeral for him with eulogies by George Harrison, by Ringo, followed by a procession with Lennon, etc. And the conspiracy in it right out the gate is that they decided, somebody told them that this would shake the country.
The country can't handle it.
They can't deal with it.
Dude, you want the queen to die, bro? Do you really? You give a shit about this country at all?
You want to be responsible for that?
And it's like his producer. He's like, we got to bring him back.
So whether, now the debate is on whether it's from the government of England or if it's from the record producer or if it's from the band itself.
I mean, the government's not getting paid.
Yeah, but they're worried about like what? Riots or burning the whole country down?
No, but it's still like... That's why I think it's like producer. He's like, do it. Do it.
I mean, they were making so much money.
Insane.
And then they held a look-alike contest to replace him. And then they found a guy in Scotland to replace him named William Campbell.
And he's also like a singer.
Scotland.
Whom then the Beatles trained to impersonate McCartney, including all his mannerisms. He had plastic surgery. And that's essentially...
I don't even know what to say.
That is essentially one of the biggest conspiracies in the world.
But who's telling the story? Like, where is the story coming from? I need... Because it's hard for me to...
Yeah.
You know me. I want to believe.
Yeah.
But who the fuck is the data coming from?
Yeah. So the first record of it being done is in a newspaper article.
By what's the newspaper? TMZ?
Like some tabloid.
I know, right? Some fucking... It's like the England scone.
The local high school newspaper or something. What the fuck?
So it was at the University of Michigan. A sophomore...
What the fuck? It's so irrelevant. It's not even in England.
A sophomore by the name of Fred Labor. He was assigned to write a review on the recently released Abbey Road for the University of Michigan newspaper. Called the Michigan...
Jorge was right.
Yeah, the Michigan Daily, right?
I'm sorry.
And apparently that's where it started, where he called into a radio station and then there was a joke about that there were clues in the Abbey Road photos, you know, you see them walking on Abbey Road, mm-hmm. and then there's mm-hmm. there's clues in there that Paul is dead, and that he was replaced with
a double.
But this guy made up this whole thing. He's like, check me out. I'm a Michigan sophomore, so I'm 19 years old. And yeah, so he picked up a hitchhiker. They were like, you know, she was, oh, fuck you. And then he got decapitated, right? And then the coppers come, and then, oh my God, and they call them all, and they come down, it's him. Like, yeah. It's a super elaborate story.
So it's very far-fetched, but here are some of the things.
Okay, I need more. Yeah. I need more.
Okay, so apparently when he died, quote-unquote, 1966, everything changed from the Beatles look to a new Beatles look. Mm-hmm. And you can remember it. They were like clean cut. They had the bowl haircuts. Mm-hmm. And they were on the Sullivan Show. And they were
all wearing the same fucking...
The yellow submarine. And they're all smiling and like they were wholesome Brits. And then apparently, supposedly, mm-hmm. afterwards, they turned into the long hair, doing LSD, deep vibe.
Like everybody else.
But wasn't that the 70s, bro?
Yep.
Exactly.
Wasn't everybody doing that?
Understood. Yeah. But that's the idea, is it completely changed from before to after.
Yeah, but they were also fucking rock stars.
I also think it's like the new guys. You guys want to try some LSD? And they're like, hey. They're like, we're going to change. Yeah. Like this one guy is like, guy. Yeah, the one guy is like pushing. He's like, this happened to have some LSD on me. He was interested. Thanks for the training. Let's get high.
A couple other things.
Know, one thing you said is this mm-hmm. new guy is supposed to be Scottish.
Yeah.
Like,
well, they trained him.
But what's his name? Okay. They gave a name, like William.
William fucking Campbell.
How did this 19-year-old guy like get this specific?
But the name changed over time, and then it became Billy Shears. So William Bill, yeah. Billy, you know, yeah. that sort of thing. Yeah.
William Campbell Shears.
Yeah. Some people say that MI5 planted him.
Okay, so it's William.
For what?
Billy Shears Campbell Shepherd.
Yeah, exactly. So his name's like, and his name evolved over time. It's very confusing.
That's what spies do.
I know. They mix it up.
Yeah. I know. He didn't need no training.
Yeah.
He was already trained.
But one theory is that the Beatles were racked with guilt, and so they didn't want to hurt their fans, so they decided to just replace him keep it going.
With guilt about the new, like, placing the new guy, or?
No, that... about losing a key member.
Guilt?
I don't. We got to understand. Just imagine us three. Let's just imagine us three for mm-hmm. a second. Mm-hmm. We get so big that we're bigger than Rogan. We're huge. We're a major influence. Mm-hmm. And then you die. And then we're racked. Sean and I are racked with guilt because Jorge is dead and he's like millions of fans.
And you're like, these and you know fans, what am I going
to
do?
The easier thing to do is just replace Jorge with another guy named Jorge.
instead of a Mexican, let's get a Puerto Rican.
Yeah. I know, right? He's like Dominican. I'm like, this doesn't feel right. And after then, the conspiracy podcast went on to like talk about baseball. Mm-hmm. like a baseball podcast.
Anyway, so there's really all of this stems from a lot of like symbols and
I want to get into these fucking symbols. Yeah. Like,
there's supposed to be a bunch of clues.
Yeah. Okay. So let's talk about Abbey Road.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Right. You know Abbey Road. Yeah. They're all walking. They're all walking. It's probably one of the more famous.
It's very iconic.
It's got to be in the top.
It's super iconic.
I mean, it's got to be in one of the top photos.
Yes, they're all like
rock and roll.
They're all mid stride.
Yeah,
like
yeah. Right. I mean.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's super cool.
Okay, so Paul has no shoes on. So that's one sign.
But what does that mean? What does that mean for anything? That
well, like
barefoot?
Yeah, going, you know, to death, walking into the afterlife.
I mean, I do think it's weird that he's the only one without shoes, but maybe he was just like a fucking hippie. I don't know.
Yeah. The other one is, you're looking at the photo right now, right?
Yeah.
Who's all in white? Lennon.
Oh, it's John?
Okay. Yeah, that's John. So the idea there is that he's the minister of walking in, like the minister of death. I'm not, this is not me. I'm not telling you. You guys, you guys look at me like, you fucking idiot.
I know. I was like,
I'm just
like,
telling you. Yeah.
Oh, I started breathing deep. I'm like, ugh. And the thing I understand, okay. So hypothetically, okay, sure. Let's say.
I mean, he's supposed to symbolize heavenly, like the angel.
Yeah, because
walking him.
Well, what's the guy? What's the guy in the back in the blue signify? The common.
George?
The common man.
Denim?
Yeah,
George
the denim.
Is in denim. Yeah. He's supposed to be the grave digger.
Oh, okay. What about the guy in the black?
The Undertaker.
And then.
Ringo's in black, right? Ringo's in black.
Yeah, and then Paul. Yeah. And then Paul's just like, this is my suit that
he's barefoot, and he's the corpse. Like, he's the going to his grave.
But a ciggy in his hand?
Yeah, it's a ciggy for sure.
Yeah, yeah. And what hand is it? What hand is it?
It's his right hand.
He's left-handed.
Well, the picture is taken from their right side. So it's not like, what?
I'm laying out the facts.
Oh my God, it's so. But it's like also like, why would they leave clues like, find out about it?
Yeah.
Like, we're going to keep it secret unless you crack the code. Right. It's like fucking whoever finds the golden ticket gets him. Like, what the fuck?
Isn't it like the biggest stretch you've ever heard?
It's so. Yes. It's
so.
Even much. I'm having a hard time believing this. And like, I want to believe it.
Right.
Let's keep going.
Isn't that wild?
Yeah.
So that's the other idea is that this guy Billy Shear, he was trained to be left-handed.
Mm.
So that's like
it's really difficult. I can barely do anything with my left hand.
Yeah. Because Paul was the only left-handed person in the band.
Mm. You
know what? Well, see, left-handed people apparently don't live as long.
Yeah.
So they find an identical lookalike that learned how to be ambidextrous.
Trained him.
Yeah. Trained to be ambidextrous.
He learned how to be indirect. Ambidextrous. Yeah, there you go.
Yeah.
And sang like him, too. And moved with him. And
They made him into a rock star because it's easy.
Not only that. Not only that. Paul was engaged at the time to a woman named Jane Asher, of which she was, quote unquote, paid to keep quiet. And then the fake Paul then married a different person named Linda Eastman, of which then... The Beatles manager, Brian Epstein, he didn't want to be part of it, so then he was killed from an overdose a couple months later.
Because he knew? Listen, I don't want to do this anymore. I don't know what the fuck. I don't know why I can't do it right now.
Yeah, that was good.
No, that's good. Yeah.
Please,
I'm just laughing at the accent.
Yeah.
Kill me.
Okay, so then this story just kind of took hold. Even in the U.S., it just took hold, which is the conspiracy that Paul was dead. It spread. So it just spread
like wildfire?
Wildfires. But a lot of people believed it, even in the U.S. And so then they started analyzing, playing songs backwards, scrutinizing the album covers.
Looking for everything.
Because every time they do this shit, they always have to leave clues.
Yeah. Right.
There's always clues on purpose. They're purposely doing shit to get found out. every time.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of this stuff comes... from people going and looking at the album covers and then
putting
some weird stuff in. I mean, these are people calling in from Iowa and then they go, hey, look at what I found.
Check this out.
Yeah. And so one of them is on the album cover of Sergeant Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. There's a freshly cut grave on the cover. Okay. Yeah, there's also a walrus on the cover of Magical Mystery Tour, which is a symbol in Viking lore of death.
A walrus is the symbol of death?
Yeah.
In Viking lore, because none of them were of Nordic descent. They're just a bunch of English dudes.
Right. And these are sleuths. These are fan sleuths that would call in and be like, oh, this is what I found.
But where's the freshly cut grave? Oh, is it like where this? Is this the thing right
Sergeant here? Sergeant Pepper's Lonely Heart.
Right here? Like, I guess maybe where the Beatles thing is? Maybe that's a grave?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. There's just a bunch of weird shit on this. I don't know.
Yeah.
So in the song, Strawberry Fields Forever, one says that you can hear Lennon say, I buried Paul.
Because he's trying to leave breadcrumbs for all of us.
Let's see.
Yeah, let's see.
You hear that? One more time. Can you give it one more time?
Yeah.
I buried Paul. And then they played the White Album's Revolution 9 backwards. So You could hear the lines, "Turn me on, dead man."
Because that means
if you do it,
turn
backwards.
Me on, dead man.
Yeah. I mean, but this is all called in to these radio stations, these college things.
People will do anything to believe.
Yeah,
they're like, no, but if you check me out, there was one time. So Paul had sneezed, and in the sneeze, you can clearly hear the binary of him saying, "I am not Paul McCartney."
What's crazy is there's a DJ, DJ Russ Gibbs. He spent hours.
DJ Russ Gibbs.
He spent hours analyzing all these lyrics, and, you know, it's just...
Clearly, he was not getting gigs.
Yeah, but check this out. If you hear this again,
okay.
Some people say that it sounds like he's saying cranberry sauce.
Yeah, let's play it again. When you're thinking cranberry sauce, kind of sounds...
Yeah, so it's kind of like... You can make it sound like whatever you want.
What if he's saying, "I'm fucking sauced"? Like, you know, like, I don't know. It's totally possible.
I mean, obviously the Beatles, and at the time they had their record recording studio was Apple. It's called Apple Recording or Apple Studios. And obviously they denied it.
Of course.
They denied it. Each band member actually denied it and said, "This is ridiculous."
Yeah.
I don't even, you know. But it kept growing, and it still grows today, and it's still one of the things, and it's that he's a fake guy, and today's fake.
It's just so. I'm sorry, because I personally believe that there are a lot of people that have been swapped out.
Or that currently have a double.
Oh yeah. I'm totally behind that.
I'm behind that.
I'm behind. There's quite a few that are
like who.
Simon Cowell, for one. Dude, have you seen that man? Dude, okay. Look at a picture of Simon Cowell now.
But that's just extreme plastic surgery.
To make him look worse? Yeah. to make him look ugly?
That's called a botch job. It's a botch job.
You know how rich Simon Cowell is, right?
Yeah.
He's worth hundreds of millions of dollars.
I know, but
you
he's
think
just,
that he... guy gets a botch job and then goes up the... Come on.
I mean...
No, he doesn't.
I mean...
It doesn't happen. That doesn't work that way. He doesn't go to like a Tijuana. I don't want to name names,
but there's a couple more out there that are like.
Oh yeah, Biden.
No, botch jobs.
Oh, sorry.
that was gonna be the one I was gonna say.
No, botch jobs.
But
back to the doubles. Who else? Okay. Biden.
So Biden.
Yeah.
Avril Lavigne.
Putin.
Oh, there's talks about Putin being swapped out. Oh, for sure. God, I used to have a whole list.
They just find a doppelganger.
Yeah,
and then
you find someone, but also there's a weird thing with like, with how masks have, have like advanced so far that it's
Mission Impossible mask. What are you talking
about, dude? They're very like that. No, and you can look at videos where like people will put them on, and like they literally go down the shoulder, so like you wear clothes over them.
Yeah.
And it looks and feels like real skin at the elasticity.
Really?
And then like they'll take it off and be like, oh, ha ha ha. Like, see, it's a fucking, it's you can get real fucking crazy.
I believe
it,
like fucking Hollywood, you can make anything look like anything.
Of course. And it'd be super
simple.
But when
you got to do this day in and day out or at least a few times here and there because you're the double, it's like.
Well, see, it's easier to do it when you're not a musician who has to play music.
Right.
And sing. When you just have to talk, it's not that hard.
Right.
There's
right.
even people that say Kanye's got body doubled out.
I've heard that.
Oh, yeah. I've heard that.
I've heard that.
Yeah.
I've heard that.
So it's like they pretty much the thing is if you start going against the grain, they say you get body doubled out. Mm. You know, you can even say, did Jack Ma get body doubled out?
Ugh.
Jack Ma disappeared for like a month and a half. Yeah. And he's like the
I remember that.
He's like billionaire.
Dude, he's like
that was during.
He's worth $40
billion. 2020.
No, you know, no, dude.
Time period.
No. Right. What happened was he started talking shit.
Yeah.
About Xi Jinping, and then he fucking whoopsie daisy. Where's Jack Ma? Where's the guy who owns Alibaba? Yeah. And then a month later, he comes back. He's like, I did not mean what I said about the Chinese government. He literally like recants like all of his shit.
He's like in Munich.
There's another Chinese actress who's the pretty much imagine like a Sandra Bullock or
the most famous woman actor
in China. Same thing. Mm. She started talking shit about she didn't like what the government was doing. She disappeared for like 6 months.
Really?
And came back randomly. and was, and then recanted, sorry, and then was like apologizing. I didn't mean it.
Yeah.
I didn't, you know, I'm so sorry. I'm such an idiot. I understand that. So like, I'm saying there are things that are.
How do you understand that?
What
do
you mean? Well, like you're super famous and then you say something.
Yeah, but how do you explain the 6 months? You're gone.
And no one, no pictures, no TMZ.
Oh yeah, you're arrested.
Oh, yeah. You're in prison.
Okay. Yeah, yeah, you're arrested. Yeah, 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 yeah,
yeah, yeah. You're being tortured. Yeah. Okay. They're torturing you in a basement in China. No.
Okay. Whether or not it's body swap doubles,
maybe. Yeah, yeah, we kind of went off on a tangent.
But they could have
different.
It could be torture. So throughout all of this whole, you know, hooting and hollering and conspiracy theory and stuff like that, McCartney wanted to keep a low profile, and so he hunkered down in a country house that he owned in Scotland. And at first.
Ooh, fancy that. Scotland. Wasn't
Shear from
Billy,
there?
Billy Shear from Scotland? Oh, crack the case.
So at first he found the whole thing funny, and it actually had a good effect on Beatles sales. So
I know, he's like
attention.
More richer.
Exactly.
Any attention is good attention.
Exactly. So, but then it grew and grew and grew, and then he turned to anger, and it reached a boiling point when Life magazine trespass on his property to get photos to prove that he was still alive. He threw a barrel of water at one of the cameramen in an angry rage for trespassing.
I'm sorry, like, who has a barrel of water just sitting around?
I know. Honestly, if you did it at your house, you'd be shot.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah.
They're trespassing? Sorry. I'm standing my ground. It was imminent threat. This is imminent.
Yeah, but if you're a celebrity and TMZ comes on your property...
That's why you hire people who then kill those people.
That's right.
It's my security detail. What am I going to do? I'm paying them to secure my property.
Exactly.
Like, when you're that rich, bro, like, I'm not doing anything myself.
I ain't pulling that trigger. I got my security for that.
I'm hungry. Make me food now. Why am I making food? Like, this is not this is out of my purview now. Like, I need food prepared for me at all times.
But then he calmed down. And he was like, oh, this is bad PR. He's like, this is not good, right? So he invited them in.
So there's like photos of him like in the moment throwing the barrel at him.
Yeah, so what he did is he invited them in and took photos with his family. And he said, just as in the agreement that you're not going to publish the photos of me raging, we're going to take good photos.
Mm.
So then he took good photos of him and his family at his Scotland farm.
And he's like, watch, I'll play some music for you.
That was in the November 7th Life magazine cover. It's him and his family in Scotland.
It's so funny. He's like pissed and they're like, we want to put you on the cover of Life magazine.
And he turned it around. Yeah, he turned it around.
But
he made it, you mean like he made it into a positive thing? Like,
yes, exactly. Yeah, yeah. Exactly. No, but here's the argument is that he was the fake. That was the fake Paul at that point.
Trying to prove that he's the real Paul.
Yes.
He said, look, I'm a family. I love people. I'm a family man. I am the real Paul.
So later on.
Oh my God, please give me something compelling.
There was an hour long special hosted by an attorney named F. Lee Bailey. Do you remember this motherfucking Lee Bailey?
Who's F. Lee Bailey?
O.J. Simpson's lawyer. You remember the lawyer who's everywhere?
No way.
Yes.
No. Okay.
This
is the most compelling piece of evidence.
F. Lee Bailey is part of every conspiracy that we've ever done.
We should do one on F. Lee Bailey. He's probably been alive he's probably like born in Transylvania in like 1802.
Fucking vampire. Part of every conspiracy for the last 300 years.
Honestly, he was a major player in O.J. Simpson. He was a major player in all of these different he's like the guy who he's like celebrity scandal, go. I'm there. I'm
pay lawyer. Me all your money.
So he did an hour-long special where he did a mock courtroom where he brought in witnesses and it was entitled Paul is Dead. And it was to grill those witnesses and go blah, 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 blah.
Oh, he's like, see, they're fucking full of shit.
Yeah.
And what happened after that?
Nothing.
No, they were like...
Yeah, nothing was proved and nothing...
They're like, guess what? It's just nothing.
We got nothing to go on.
It's the same thing.
Yeah.
Nothing's changed.
Yeah. So in the interview for that Life magazine, McCartney said that the rumor was bloody stupid. Do it in the right accent.
Bloody stupid. Harry!
Such a certain.
Bloody hell.
It's a certain area of England that you're doing. It's not all of the areas.
I'm doing a Ron Weasley. Mm-hmm. For the Ron Weasley accent.
Yeah. And so in 1970, Rolling Stone interview with John Lennon, he was asked about the death story. He responded, he said, "I don't know where that started. That was barmy."
What the fuck does barmy mean? Does that mean like bullshit?
I don't know. Please, our English folk, can you guys tell us what barmy means?
Fuck bollocks!
This is barmy! "I don't know. You know as much about it as me. No, that was bullshit. The whole thing was made up. We never went for anything like that. We put tit 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 in girl. It would be things like a beat missing or something like that. See if anyone noticed. I know we used to have a few things, but nothing could be interpreted like that." So he's saying they did put a couple of funny things in the album and in the songs, but he never really did anything crazy.
And also, like why would we do that? Why would we try to get caught? I don't understand. Yeah, like, exactly. What the fuck? Like, just don't put anything in the album cover. Yeah.
So that's pretty much it. I mean, there's a lot of things in the album cover, you know?
That are weird. The album cover's weird.
I know. It's very weird.
Oh, it's just super weird. I don't understand any of it.
And there's just where a hand is resting, and you go, oh, that hand symbolizes, you know.
Paul McCartney's grave is reaching out from the grave.
There's also, like, a part of the cover that looks like it has a date and says he died.
Oh, right. The Roman numerals and
In Roman numerals.
Yeah,
but when you look at it,
Jorge showed me this picture and I can't find every other album cover of the same thing. I looked at, I can't find it. I think it was doctored. Yeah. This is doctored.
I mean, this is such a silly. I don't know. You know,
my biggest thing is okay. You find a body double, you give him some plastic surgery. Looks like Paul. Got it.
Yeah.
But being able to train him to be left-handed and to play the guitar left-handed and sing songs and be good, sound like Paul McCartney,
he moves like him. Yeah. He talks like him.
Also, did you know? I mean, most people know this who grew up in that time period, but he started a band called Wings. Paul McCartney was in a band called Wings, and they had like 6 number one hits.
So this body double just happened
to be
like
in the 80s, in the 70s and 80s, like when they broke up.
This is an amazing musician. He decided to be this amazing musician.
No, you're not going to have that talent as a double.
I mean, because I think it's like if you could just do that, I'd be like, make me LeBron.
Yeah, yeah.
Just train me to be an elite athlete right now. Done. Easy peasy. Just plastic surgery on me.
Yeah.
Just plastic surgery
on
me.
Bring that seed a little bit back.
Just cut that hairline off.
Yeah, and bring it back a little bit.
Then plug it.
Think about it. Okay, so the cops that found, that showed up to the incident.
They got to be paid off.
They got to be paid off and kept quiet for years, decades.
The girl who's getting handsy in the car.
Yeah, that Rita, too.
She got to get paid off.
So that was the other part. They did a song, and it was about... You know, Rita.
But did they say Rita? It was probably just about a girl.
No, but
like,
John
it's about Rita.
John talks about Rita as like a maid. It's debatable. It's all debatable. I don't know.
Maybe he's talking about Margarita.
I don't know. Ooh, that's why I say it's all debatable. Yeah, everything you can look into and be like,
just fans.
You know, why are you
like
wearing
look
that
into
shirt?
It.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. That shirt's blue, right?
See what happened. Yeah.
What are you against blue eyed people? Are you racist? Oh, you don't like white people? Because they only got blue eyes. I know, just complicated.
Just reaching, trying to find anything. Just to make my point, I'm just saying, like, okay, there's so many people that had to kept quiet for so long,
for decades.
It's just too improbable, you know? Yeah.
They actually had like eulogies and all this shit. So everybody at the funeral
was
getting silenced.
Also, the motive is not that good.
There was no motive. He apparently just died.
What's the motive?
Oh, well, the motive of doubling is to sell millions and millions of records.
Do you think that they wouldn't have kept selling records?
No, they probably would have sold more.
Yeah.
It's like Van Gogh.
Yeah, that's true.
Mm. Well, when you die, they become super popular. They wouldn't have been able to make any more full Beatles albums.
Yeah.
But once someone, like, look at Kurt Cobain. Once he died, it's like Nirvana became immortalized forever.
True. But then the other way, too, is that I'm seeing Stone Temple Pilots on Sunday.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, and the lead singer is not the original. Mm. I don't think they've been doing as well.
I see.
Do you know what I mean? Since
Yeah, and the Beatles are the
right?
Beatles,
that's
and
the other
it's
way
like
around,
a,
right?
It is like a.
I hate when you guys you guys roll your eyes.
Tit for tat. Tit for tat.
You guys roll your eyes. You're a fucking idiot.
Beatles. Back to the
same.
Back to the beginning.
Stone Temple Pilots. Is not
back to the beginning. These are fucking mega star, like
billions,
phenomenal. What do you call it? Phenom or whatever the word is.
Top five of all time.
All time. All time. Easily. All
top three.
Right now, still. Still. And think back to, you know, they were. Top, whatever, back in the 60s. It's, it was just...
Yeah. Just imagine, imagine it's like this, sorry. Just like imagine Beethoven, you know, goes on a bender, and he's like, and he's like some hooker, and he like dies, and they're like, oh, shit. Like, we just sold out the amphitheater. We got to get Beethoven back in there. Let's find a body double. And they're like, oh, we'll just train him to play the piano. Easy.
I know. It doesn't make sense,
we'll just train him.
He's a phenom.
Like, I know. He's a fucking... Like, you can't just do what he does.
Yeah.
Let me ask you a question. Yeah, because now we also did Mount Rushmore recently. Who's the Mount Rushmore of music?
Oh my God!
Music in general? In general?
That's so ridiculous.
That's impossible.
Four?
That's impossible.
No, it's not. Come on.
Four.
Of all time.
I would definitely Beethoven. Sure.
Beethoven. Up there. Yeah, and it's still selling to this day.
Does it have to be one person or a band or anybody?
It's a head, bro. You can't have like a band.
Well, okay.
You gotta pick one motherfucker.
You gotta pick one
motherfucker.
Four.
No, I'm saying like
four people.
Oh, yeah, the Beatles counts as one.
That's what I'm
if
saying.
If you were to do the Beatles, one.
Okay. Get the fuck out of here. Then it's not Mount Rushmore. What kind of Mount Rushmore is this?
Like they're condensed. They're like, eh.
Oh, it's eh. So essentially,
top
you're just saying top four.
Music.
Beethoven, MJ.
I was going to say MJ.
Ooh.
I was going to say MJ.
MJ for sure. 100%. King of pop, baby. Come on.
Elvis.
Elvis. Go. I don't know. Elvis?
Tupac. No, I'm just kidding. No.
Frank Sinatra.
You just want to fight, Sean.
What is this?
Okay,
like,
take it back. Take it back. Take it back.
Rapist Rushmore? What the fuck?
Take it back. We can take it back.
All right. So MJ.
Definitely not Sinatra.
Beatles?
It's
nobody in any other language. Like, what the fuck?
I mean, the last 30 years.
Andre Bocelli?
Also, the last.
I mean, hey, he's up there.
Dude, he's amazing. I love Andre Bocelli.
The last 30 years, anything? Last 30 years, we haven't had one that was in the top four?
Eminem?
Crazy, right?
Yeah,
it's really hard because
it's not crazy. It's just really hard. You're like you're thinking through everything
because you're trying to think of like people who are like savants. Like Beethoven was savant. Like he was what he did. People were how is this even possible? Even today, how is this possible? He wrote this music that's impossible.
Sebastian Bach.
That's
back in that time.
Yeah. I don't know. I would need like time. I need time to fucking formulate this list.
Okay.
Like I can't do this.
All right. Well,
and it's also subjective too. It's based on what your music.
Okay, so where are you at? Paul McCartney.
That's it, man. I
think he's 100% alive.
Yeah.
You think this is all bullshit?
I think it's all bullshit. I just think.
But how is this? Still, we did two episodes of these are the top conspiracies on the planet.
I think
it's one of those things, kind of like Tupac, right? We did Tupac. We did an episode.
No, but that one is a little bit suspect.
You're right.
You got shot in Vegas Strip. Like,
that's right.
Crazy.
You're right.
That's
There's
weird.
Definitely a lot more that can sustain our conspiracies on that one. But what I was going to say is Tupac, Bob Marley, whatever, famous people. Yeah. I think people just make up shit that if they hear somebody dies, then they start making up all these clues or whatever. And then it just kind of like took off. Yeah. And it had like a life on its own, like this conspiracy, but happens to be super fake. I don't buy it at all.
I just think there's too many variables.
Too improbable.
It's so improbable. Like with these other ones, we've done, there's room for speculation. So I can totally get behind.
Yeah.
It could be possible.
Right.
This just seems, there's no evidence at all. There's zero. There's not even
things that make you go, hmm.
There's not even a credible source. The guy who wrote the paper was a 19-year-old kid in Michigan. It's not even like, if he was-
I wonder where this guy is now.
If he was at the Cambridge newsletter, I'd be like, okay.
Maybe.
I can get behind that. It's literally in Michigan, U of M. Anyways, there's no credible resources. I think it's just everyone wants to, it's really easy when it's something like the Beatles to It probably was an internet troll who started it, and then like
internet,
started, and then started
troll.
Getting like
back in the '60s.
This like mad following,
I know, right? 1966.
It was like a.
He's like, wait a minute.
It's like a, also, newspaper troll.
By the way, think about this also. Okay, so the way he sounds before and after, you would be able to pick up something. You know, the way he...
Or maybe if he couldn't like, play an instrument or he couldn't sing.
But like, let's say the guy could play an instrument, the one that they found.
The Scottish guy.
Yeah. But also just like his voice, you know? Let's say you could train his mannerism. Let's say he could be ambidextrous.
Let's say
everybody stays quiet. Right?
let's keep saying.
Such a hard sell. It's not like Tupac on, you know, the strip.
In Cuba.
And he's dead. I know. And he's dead. Nobody knows who killed him. Yeah.
Allegedly.
That's true.
It's just too loose.
Yeah.
I want to believe. Trust me. I'm like, I am the believer. I want to believe.
Yeah.
Because I believe that a lot of weird shit does happen. And I believe that the whole body double thing is a real thing. Just not here.
Yeah. But last question is, so why? Okay. So you go and you search top 10 conspiracies on Earth of all time. Mm-hmm. This is like number 8.
Well, you know why? Because it's the Beatles. The Beatles are one of the top 3 bands to ever have lived, and therefore any conspiracy involving them is instantly going to get views.
It's like instantly so much attention. It's like back to the beginning of what we're talking about.
So much attention.
They just want more content, meaning the viewers.
Of course, it's really easy.
More content about that.
Yeah, no one's going to make a thing about, you know, Joe Schmo at the fucking hardware store and like, oh, shit, he got replaced. Yeah. He's just been acting different.
Yeah.
I know, he doesn't know the aisles anymore. Like I asked him the other day, he couldn't tell me where the nails were.
Yeah,
no one cares.
All right. I agree. I think this is absurd.
Yeah.
I still don't really grasp how it keeps going.
I don't understand.
It's in the top.
It has to be just because there's so much popularity to the Beatles.
All of the top tens have some basis. There's some basis.
I know what it is.
This is probably the least of all of the top ten.
Yeah. It's clickbait.
Yeah, exactly.
Clickbait.
You say Beatles, Paul McCartney, John Lennon.
Oh, dude. Blah, blah, blah. Everyone's going to read it. Oh, my God.
Us.
What?
We're going to clickbait this shit.
We're going to clickbait the shit out of this.
You better listen, motherfuckers, because it's real.
Well, no, I am very, very curious what the poll looks like on this one.
I'm also curious if anyone knows anything that we don't. Like, if you guys know, I just want one little nugget that I could sink my teeth into, then I'll switch sides.
I'll happily switch sides.
Like, I want to believe that he's fake.
Usually it's all the album stuff and the symbolism of the white outfit, and you know,
but
that's
that symbolism is super weak.
I know.
I'm listening
to the words backwards, and
it's like, and I'm sorry, what gravedigger have you ever seen wear a denim suit? I've not seen one, not a singular dude.
No. The gravedigger was the black suit.
No, the gravedigger was a denim suit. The black suit was the Grim Reaper.
Yeah.
Oh, that's right.
He was just in his regular suit barefoot.
The white suit was the.
But I'm
angel brain.
But the thing is, have you ever seen a man buried barefoot in a suit? No. That does not. They don't do that. They put shoes on that motherfucker. Why would he wear a suit and no shoes?
Yeah.
I don't know. It's just ridiculous.
It's a weird one. But we're going to do a poll, and I am very curious. I want to know what is believed. Is this a true thing, or is this
just
media?
It's just a constant troll. It's like a media troll.
Yeah, it's a media
ruse.
Driven. Yeah.
Yeah.
There you go. All right, there you go. Paul McCartney, everybody. Hey, buddy, if you're out there, Sir Paul. I think you're the real deal, buddy.
Actually, here's the real thing. Paul, if you really are you have to email us.
Give us a little tweet.
If you don't,
come on the podcast.
Wait, what is it called? X now?
Yeah, if you X us, we need an X.
Such a stupid name.
No, I'm sorry.
I'm going to start a company called Triple X. Elon.
No, but seriously, Paul, if you X us, we'll know that you're real, but you have to tag us. Otherwise, you're fake, and this is a real conspiracy.
Exactly.
Please, God, retweet this.
for our own financial sake.
Literally, I will get a tattoo of you on my chest if you fucking tweet this shit out, bro. I swear to God, I will.
Damn.
Anyways.
Imagine if he does.
I'll get a tattoo on my chest. I'm not even around. I will do it.
All right,
it may
y'all.
Not be big, but it'll be on my chest.
All right.
All right, y'all. That's what we got tonight. There you go.
Hopefully you guys loved it, enjoyed it. Leave us a review if you haven't yet, by the way.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And keep your eyes peeled. We got big stuff coming. Patreon, exclusive content. Yeah. It's coming. Coming to you.
One of these days we have pyramids.
Yeah, I was just going to say, we want some ideas from you guys. Anything that you know that is a conspiracy that we haven't done, something that you suggest, email us at info@theconspiracypodcast.com or just follow us on socials and send us a message.
Yeah, they'll DM. But that's do have like
Eric. We do have a couple. We have, we have 9/11.
9/11.
Pyramids.
Big boy.
RFK.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Not RFK Jr., but RFK. RFK. The assassination of Robert F. Kennedy.
And then there's even...
We got a Bilderbergs.
The Bilderbergs.
We got what else do we have?
Do you say pyramids?
Rockefellers.
Yeah.
The Rockefellers.
Oh, my God.
Jesus. There's a lot. Christ. There's a lot coming. Anyways, all right, everybody.
Night and night.
Hey, guys. Hope you enjoyed the show. If you want to reach out to us, please email us at info@theconspiracypodcast.com. You can check us out on Instagram at @aconspiracypodcast. Also, don't forget to subscribe. You can catch a new podcast almost every week. Just hit the little subscribe button at the top. It's a plus sign. We love show ideas, corrections, hate mail. Thanks a bunch.